History Chapter 7 The Administration of the Swaraj. As you know, Shivaji Maharaj founded the Swaraj. He had himself crowned as Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj in the coronation ceremony. After the coronation ceremony, he was successful in campaign of South. The campaign of South is also known as Dakshin Digvijay. The Swaraj expanded large areas of Nashik, Pune, Satara, Sangli, Kolhapur, Sindhudurg, Ratnagiri, Raigad, Thane districts of Maharashtra, some parts of Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu states. So, for the smooth working of the Swaraj and for the welfare of the people as well as to protect the conquered territories, Shivaji Maharaj set up an efficient administration. Let us know in details. Ashtapradhan Mandal of Shivaji Maharaj. Explanation. After the time of coronation, Shivaji Maharaj appointed 8 council of ministers. The administration was divided into 8 departments. A head was appointed for each department. These 8 heads of department were known as Ashtapradhan Mandal or Council of 8 Ministers. Shivaji Maharaj had the power to appoint and to remove the head of the department. The ministers can give and take advice for the administration of their respective departments. Maharaj selected the Council of Ministers on the basis of the merits and achievements. He paid handsome salaries instead of jagirs, vetans or gifts or fifths, meaning of fifths, an estate of land. I hope this point is clear to you. Next point, the policy regarding the agriculture. Explanation. Agriculture was the main occupation in villages. Maharaj knew the importance of agriculture. So, he paid attention to the welfare of farmers. He gave the responsibility of organizing the land revenue system to his capable and experienced officer Annaji Datto. So, Shivaji Maharaj gave some instructions to his officers. And the instructions were, he warned the officers that they should not collect more revenue than the amount that was fixed. He encouraged peasants to bring uncultivated land under cultivation. Suppose if the crop was lost due to excessive rains or drought, or if an enemy army had devastated, that is destroyed, the area of the village, remissions were granted in land revenue and other taxes. Meaning of remissions, discount. Maharaj instructed his officers to give peasants bullocks, plows and good seeds for sowing. I hope this point is clear. Next point, village economy at that period. Explanation. Agriculture was the backbone of the villages. Many occupations developed to support agriculture. Artisans produced goods and fulfilled the need of the local people. Therefore, a village was self-sufficient unit. Meaning of self-sufficient, able to produce or provide everything that you need without anybody's help. So, farmers gave a particular share from their produce to artisans. This share was called as baluta. I hope this point is clear to you. Next point, trade and business. Explanation. Maharaj knew that a kingdom will not grow without an increase in trade. Merchants bring novel goods and certain necessary articles to the kingdom. Novel goods means the things which are not produced in the village. That has to be brought from another place. So this is known as novel goods. So merchants bring novel goods and certain necessary articles to the kingdom. Therefore, goods were available in plenty. Trade and wealth began to grow together. In Ajnanapatra, merchants are described as ornaments of the kingdom and the glory of the king. It was the policy of Maharaj to protect industries. Here is an excellent example given about salt industry. Traders imported salt from Portuguese territory and it was brought into Swaraj. Now this affected the local areas of Konkan. So Maharaj, what he did? Maharaj charged heavy duty on the salt imported from the Portuguese territory. The main aim was the salt from Portuguese territory will cost more, and as a result, import of Portuguese salt will decrease and local salt will increase. Likewise, people will start buying local salt. I hope this point is clear to you. Next point, the military organization. You have studied about military organization in the previous class also. Explanation: there are two main divisions of the army of Shivaji Maharaj, infantry and cavalry. Let us know about infantry. There were officers such as Havaldar, Jumledar, etc. The chief of infantry was Sarnobat. Sarnobat was the highest officer in infantry. Now let us know about cavalry. In cavalry, there were Shiledars and Bargirs. The highest ranking cavalry officer was Sarnobat. Let us know about Shiledars. The Shiledars had his own horse and weapons. Let us know about Bargirs. The Bargir was provided with a horse and weapons by the state. Bargirs were more in numbers. The rank of the cavalry officers were similar to those of the infantry officers. Netoji Palkar, Pratap Rao Gujar, Hambir Rao Mohite were some of the famous Sarnobats of the cavalry. I hope this point is clear. Next point, intelligence department. Explanation: it was necessary that Swaraj must have an intelligence department. Why? What is the use? To protect Swaraj from enemies. To get correct and time to time information about the enemy. So it was the job of intelligence department to do that and inform it to Shivaji Maharaj. Let us know about Bihirji Naik. Bihirji Naik was the head of the intelligence department. He was extremely skilled in his job. He collected accurate and detailed information about Surat before Shivaji Maharaj attacked Surat. So I hope this point is clear to you. Next point, forts. Explanation: in the medieval period, forts were very important. They say if one has fort, it was possible to keep an eye on the enemy territory. Let us take an example. If any foreign country is attacking Swaraj, it was possible to protect people by taking shelter in the fort. It was possible to stock the food with food grains, war materials, ammunitions and military garrison. Meaning of garrison: a group of troops or army. The importance of forts is mentioned in Ajnanapatra. This kingdom was created by the late revered and exalted majesty forts alone. Let us know about the forts of Swaraj in detail. There were about 300 forts in the Swaraj. Maharaj spent a lot of money in building and repairing and doing maintenance of these forts. forts like Pratapgarh, Pavangarh, Rajgarh, etc. was built by Shivaji Maharaj. There were Kiledars, Asabnis and Karkhanis on every fort. Now let us know the duties of Karkhanis. The Karkhanis looked after the storage of food grains and the maintenance of war material in the fort. I hope this point is clear to you. Let us know about the sea fort. Explanation: Maharaj knew the importance of sea fort also. He built Sindhudurg fort at Malwan. It is an excellent sea fort, you must see. To keep the foundation strong, 5 khandis of lead was poured into the foundation of making Fort Sindhudurg. Now let us know about Fort Patmadurg. A sea fort called Patmadurg was built in front of Rajapuri in order to counter the Siddhi power. Meaning of to counter: an attack made in response to one by an opponent. So by building this fort, Maharaj has said in his letter that he had set up another Rajapuri to overshadow the Rajapuri of Siddhi. That means Siddhis already had a fort named Rajapuri. It was a powerful fort. Like Rajapuri, same fort was built by Shivaji Maharaj also. Why? If the Siddhis would attack the Swaraj, it was possible for Shivaji Maharaj to attack from this fort. This fort means Fort Patmadurg. Okay, that is why Shivaji Maharaj has told in his letter that he had set up another Rajapuri to overshadow the Rajapuri of Siddhi. Meaning of overshadow: a tower above and cast a shadow over. So I hope this point is clear to you. Next point, navy. There were many enemies who put obstacle in the work of expanding the Swaraj. There were many navies on the western coast of India. The Portuguese of Goa, the Siddhi of Janjira, the British factors of Surat and Rajapur. So it was necessary to stop their activities and to protect the western coast. So for this purpose, Maharaj had to raise the navy. He realized that one who has a navy can control the sea. Maharaj had a great foresight. Meaning of foresight: ability to predict the future. Now let us know about the concern for the welfare of the subject. Concern for the welfare of subject means to be worried about the people in his kingdom. Explanation: Maharaj not only for the expansion of the Swaraj, but his main concern was his people. He not only struggled to expand the areas of the Swaraj, but he was much worried about the people. Why? Due to the attacks from the enemies. He wanted to see people enjoying freedom in Swaraj. So, administration was needed for the welfare of the people and to look after the conquered territories. Maharaj was not only a ruler, he was an excellent administrator who cared for the welfare of the people. Then that can be seen in the Swaraj. So, students, I hope this chapter is clear to you. Thank you.